Signed, sealed, delivered.
Bam.
Boom, in your face.
Dr. Paul here. We're gonna go take a look at a child who, oh my goodness, sore throat, fever, lethargic, swollen lymph nodes. What the heck?
In the summertime.
In the summertime. Hello.
Hello.
Hey, how are you guys doing?
Sore throat, fever. Anybody else been sick that you've been around? Nope. Okay. Have you done any traveling?
We went to Disneyland like 2 weeks ago.
In Disneyland?
Yeah.
Okay.
Yeah, but she's been vaccinated and we've been vaccinated.
So. You had the COVID vaccine?
Yeah, she had the Johnson & Johnson.
How long ago?
A while ago.
May.
Yeah.
Okay. And you guys did fine with it? You haven't had any problems?
Oh yeah, I was fine.
Yeah. Okay. We had the symptoms that later that night.
Yeah, but that was it. And it was just away. Like, you know, the fever okay. chills thing.
All right.
Well, her college required it.
So. Yeah.
Otherwise, they were going to make her go to nasal swabs twice a week.
Oh my gosh.
Just to get on campus.
What college is that?
Chapman.
Oh, Chapman in California?
Yeah.
Okay. And just see what we find here. A fine looking ear. Another great looking ear. Let's see your throat. You have a beautiful musical ah. I bet you could do ah with a whole octave.
Ah.
That was great.
That was so good.
That was the best ah we've ever had.
That was so good.
Nice. Have you thought about doing the voice?
I mean, I was one too when I was little.
Yeah.
But I was more into musical theater and all that.
So. When you were little, how old are you?
I mean, I'm 18.
Okay.
She's older now. Big breath. Again? In case there's evidence of allergies or whatever. That side, your right nostril is very swollen, which is generally allergies, although you'll tend to get it on both sides
okay.
with that.
Huh.
What yeah. are you hunting for?
Well, I don't wonder if your nose is perfectly straight.
Oh, I don't think it is, no.
I don't think it is.
Unless it happened when you were really little and you Remember when you fell into that door frame?
I did fall into that door frame.
Yeah, that you do have a deviated nasal septum. It's just a matter of symmetry is all.
Because we...
Gotta have fun, gotta be creative. Cool.
We have a musical ah, and we've got the first nostril imaging we've done. So you're gonna go down in history, famous.
Yeah, for, that's exactly how I pictured it.
Just for funsies, I'm gonna swab your throat. Sorry. This is a rapid strep. This one has some goobers on it. I'm just gonna stick it in there.
Musical goobers.
That's the backup. This is the one that's gonna do it on a rapid.
Okay.
And when our rapids are negative, we back them up with a traditional throat culture.
That did not fit
off. That was a really good
shot.
Okay.
So we're gonna send this off to the nurse to get going.
She does have a history of having strep.
I'm just so mysterious like that.
Yeah.
You may be colonized with streps. Well, you know, certain bacteria are just at peace with us.
Okay.
Your throat doesn't hurt right now, or it does.
It does.
It does?
A little bit, yeah.
Mm-hmm. All right. Well, if it's strep, we'll treat it. If it's not, we'll wait for the mystery call in 2-3 days. Yeah, you do have it
yeah,
after
it was
all.
Strep.
Yeah. When are you headed back to school?
My move-in day is August 24th.
Woo-hoo! But we leave on the 21st.
Okay, so you got another, not quite a month, 3 weeks. How are you feeling about going off to college?
I'm nervous to, you know, just sort of start over.
Yeah.
Because in California, but I'm really excited.
What are you going to major in? Do you know?
I'm majoring in theater, but I'm planning on double majoring in engineering.
Good deal. Dorm or a sorority or what?
Dorm.
Dorm?
Yeah, okay. I have my roommate and that's all cool.
Okay, so. That's exciting. Well, I like to let anybody going off to college, because I did it once upon a time.
Like a 1,000 years ago.
A really long time ago. I am in my 60s, so yeah.
Yeah, man, you're old.
I'm old. Even my hair is turning gray.
You still have it, though.
I got the wrinkles to prove it. You know, it's an amazing experience for most people. But in rare cases, it can be just like a disaster. My first year, I left Africa. I ended up in Kalamazoo, Michigan. Long story short, it was a really bad fit for me. I switched schools and went from Kalamazoo, Michigan to California. good choice, California. And I was so much happier. Let's say you get there and it's just, it is a disaster and you happen to end up being depressed and anxious and realize that you're not sure and you don't want to disappoint your parents and tell them. Would you mind if she called you and said, Mom?
No.
No, okay.
We've already had that conversation
okay,
with her.
Good. I just think it's worth knowing that. There's nothing worth being stuck somewhere doing something that you're absolutely miserable. You can always redirect. We're gonna get a strep result.
Oh yeah, let's go see it.
Shall we see how late our result is? Dun, 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 dun. We're coming in to look for a strep result. All right, we only have one red line. If there were two, that would be a positive strep. We will send a routine culture off to the lab. We'll get that result in 2 to 3 days and call the patient back if it's positive. Okay, so.
Yes?
It was negative.
Negative. Oh my God, what a big surprise. That is so crazy.
Oh my gosh, so we got a backup culture going, we'll call you.
Okay.
No news is good news.
But no need for like a COVID test or anything?
No.
Okay.
No, absolutely not. You guys, thanks for watching and we'll see you next time. I'm Dr. Paul.